It sure is, Kirk and Marianne. Kirk's going to kick things off with a drill.
Yeah, a lot of us got to get that resume out there. You're trying to get a new job, and 78% of people say that they have misrepresented themselves on the resume. They lied. On the resume.
Did you say 70?
78%.
I would say more like 98%.
You got no faith in mankind?
No, but have you? Everybody.
Hand up high.
Pumps up their resume, fluffs up job titles.
If you went to Harvard or Princeton, you don't need to.
No, but jobs, people have definitely.
Oh, yeah.
You make it sound the best you can.
No doubt about it. I know I have. 60% of people have lied about mastery and skills that they only had a passing knowledge in. I get that.
Yeah, yeah.
You want to get the job and you know it'll tell you must be proficient at bit, and you'll say, yeah, I got those.
It's just, I don't know if it's lying. It's fluffing.
You're a fluffer.
Volumizing your resume. Like if you, you know, were if you were a secretary, you might say you were admin specialist.
There you go.
There's just wordage that people use.
Yeah. Other common resume fibs, if you want to call them. False reason for leaving a job, 45%. You may have quit and or you may have been fired and say you moved on at your own volition.
Yeah, you know what? Thinking about it, it's probably never a good explanation. Well, I left. They don't want to see that you move around a lot.
But they don't want to see you got fired either.
And they don't want to see you were fired if you were cut. What is it? Laid off?
Laid off.
Because of budget cuts, which is what my job told me. But I felt like I felt like I got fired, but they said I was being laid off.
But that's better to say, that budget cut thing you just threw out there. That makes it look like it's not my fault. Budget.
Right.
Try that. That's probably what they're talking about. False reason.
And, I mean, I think bosses can see through all this anyway.
Maybe it's a new boss. First timer. Just looking at resumes.
You were fired?
Other ones. Made up relevant experiences, 42%. Using a director title when you were just a manager, 41.25%. And listing a degree from a prestigious university instead of their own, 39%. And while that might seem like a bad thing.
Well, that's easy to prove.
Just call the university and be like, hey, Marianne Sirk, did she graduate?
We have no record of her, sir. I know all the names off the top of my head.
Marianne, who? You might think that that's going to throw you out of the mix, but managers don't seem to mind if you lie on your resume. 66% of managers say they're willing to accept misrepresentations on the resume, and they're most lenient about pumping up your GPA.
Who puts their GPA on a resume?
I don't think I did. You know what my trick was? I mean, not really.
Unless it was great, then I guess you wouldn't.
Well, if you're not going to take it down, you're going to take it up. But on mine, if it's great, you leave it alone, right?
Right. I mean, if you got an award for your high GPA, you might want to note it. But otherwise, you're not going to say 3.2.
So I was at the University of Maryland for 4 years, didn't graduate, but I just put University of Maryland,
those four years,
and make it seem like I may have gotten out with the sheepskin.
They could assume what they want.
And the worst thing managers say you can do is fake a reference. 54%, over half of hiring managers say they would never hire somebody who faked a reference.
Fake a reference. Now, the reference is the easiest part. You call your friends.
Yeah, say you're my boss.
Yeah.
You were my boss.
I've done that a lot. Well, but, you know, you also call your friends and you go, hey, somebody might call you. Please put in a good, you know.
Exactly.
I've gotten that phone call and text from friends quite a bit. And lying about where you went to school, I think is a very
that's
bold, stupid lie. But fluffing up what you've done,
sure,
I would overlook. But I'd be pretty surprised if an employer overlooked Harvard versus a community college, you know?
And if you're going to, as you say, fluff it up a little bit, you got to make it so they can't go back.
Truth.
But they can't go back and catch you in a bold-faced lie. It's got to end somewhere that there's nobody to call and check on you.
Yeah.
If, you know, say you got an award from some organization that no longer exists.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, Brandon's got an idea. What's up, Brandon?
Hey, how you guys doing?
We're good. What do you think?
Happy Valentine's Day.
Thank you.
Same to you.
So, just a little advice for the people who like to lie on the resumes, or fluff up, as you guys say. It's just best to be honest. If the description is calling for experience and you don't have it, let them know. and let them know that you'd also want to get the experience.
Yeah.
As a manager, it's just that in itself, I've seen honesty take itself a long, long way.
I hear what you're saying, but I remember Rick said,
novel idea.
Rick said, you know, we're not looking for on-the-job training. Thanks a lot. And then he moves on to the next guy, our boss.
Mm. It's all about how you sell yourself.
Yeah, it's true.
All right, man. Honesty is a pretty good policy. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, I remember getting interviewed for a cocktail waitressing position at a little place that I ended up being at for years. And right at the end, I felt like I think I had been at a diner. I'd been at Friendly's. Mm-hmm. I'd been at Macaroni Grill and a diner in Manhattan. So not a ton of what they were looking for. They wanted Manhattan fancy stuff. And I was at a comedy club and doing serving. And at the very, I just felt like he wasn't buying what I was offering.
Well, I'm feeling you.
And at the very end, I offered to have sex with him. No, just kidding. At the very end,
I was like, damn, job. Sealed it up.
Yeah. At the very end, I go, I could do this, just so you know. Like, I can completely do this. I've been in this situation before.
I
serve real, real, real fast. If you're looking for speed, I've got it. I've done sales in well over 1,000 a night. Like, I just gave a final eye contact plea.
And how did it turn out?
After sex.
How'd the date turn out?
Great. He did call me. But I remember feeling the change.
Yeah.
Like, because I sensed it was leaving, and I'm like, wait.
And, you know, not to change the subject, but actors do that, too. They're like, I can do this. It's like Glenn Close had to do that for Fatal Attraction. Everybody, they think, you can't do this role. She's like, you're giving me this role.
Oh, I don't know that story.
Oh, yeah. She's like, I got this, okay? Yeah. And then they're like, okay.
What'd she do? Something crazy, like boil a bunny in the audition?
I don't think she boiled the bunny in there, but she let them know that this is my role.
Go there, yeah.
Sometimes you gotta do it like that.
Yeah, I've never booked a commercial that way.
Be bold. There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com, the 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.